Well, guys, welcome back to our another podcast here. This week I'm back and Z Chum is out and
Things we've is got back. A special guest. Yay!
Special guest Fobtac, who
and
really deserves
Z Chum is gone.
Wow.
Yay! Gone. We have Fobtac instead, who's better than Z Chum. That's what I said about you last time. King, sorry. But welcome to the show, Fobtac, everybody. Round of applause.
Thank you. I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
You're honored. Fobtac is a Twitch streamer, YouTuber. Surprise, surprise, you know. Yeah. And just like everyone else on this podcast and everyone we've ever had on, but pretty much. Very
It's a little
unique.
Bit different, though. Yeah, it's a little unique.
Not a stinky little gamer like the rest of us. He has a very unique stream. I've never seen anything else quite like it on the entire platform, pretty much. extensive green screen use. Actually, we have some clips that, just to give you a little reference throughout this thing so you know what we're talking about. But Fobtac, it's like a chatting stream slash skateboarding slash... trying to do skateboarding tricks while holding delicate objects. A lot of like going to different places via green screen. A lot of characters coming in and out. You've seen Fobtac on some intros on mm-hmm. the gamer hole, actually. Yes. Like Arnold Schwarzenegger. I mean, don't want to give
I'm
that
really
away.
That, Arnold.
It, I
that
mean,
was Arnold.
I like to think it was actually Arnold, but it was Fobtac. So glad you're on the show, Fob.
Thank you. Thank you for having me and thank you for that lovely intro.
It's the least I could do for someone of your stature.
Humble me down a bit.
But first off, I just want to say the skateboarding thing, I'm still upset with you. So if everyone doesn't know this, Fobtac is he is quite good at skateboarding and does skateboard on stream, but the holding delicate things upsets me. The whole time I watch you skateboard with delicate things in your hands, I don't know why. It's almost like an OCD tick where I'm like, don't drop it. Don't do it. And I know that that's what you're doing it for. But when you did that to the Star Destroyer, the whole Lego set that probably took hours and hours and hours to put together and it just gets destroyed. Ugh.
We should edit that in right now.
Do it before my arms get too tired. Okay, I'm just gonna go for it. Let's see if I can get Rock to Thinky while holding the Star Destroyer. I broke the Star Destroyer. Well, I'm glad you all were here to see that.
Have fun with that, Ben.
Thanks, Ben. This is a high-level production now, thanks to our members. Thank you, members. We have an editor, so we can do things like that now. Actually make video references of what the hell we're talking about all the time, which is great. Great, great, great.
But yeah, could you stop doing that? That's all my request for you.
Okay. I won't do it anymore.
Okay, I'm going to also
like,
make
God.
A request. Bob, don't stop doing that because I love watching that.
It's oh, okay. So, okay, I'll start it again. I had taken a hiatus for a few seconds, but
What is the worst item that you've like broken or fragile item you've held during that? Because I think the Star Destroyer is my most upsetting one, but what's the biggest one you think?
See, and it's interesting because I love Legos as much as, you know, any adult fan of Lego, and for some reason dropping the Star Destroyer doesn't irk me quite as much. I feel like there's been a couple where it's like a lot of cleanup and kind of not really worth it almost. Like on Halloween once I was holding like jelly brains or something on a plate and I was like trying to go up and down a half pipe and they were just flying everywhere and there was pieces all over the ramps and all over the ground, and I feel like that one I kind of thought, okay, maybe I won't do that again next time. So probably the messy ones.
I would avoid glitter.
Oh, I hadn't even thought of that.
Yeah, or that might be really fun.
Hey, yeah, sounds like you got ideas for your next one.
Yeah,
just like a
giant bowl of glitter.
Yeah. Huh. And if I spill a single, would it be a single glit? Then
yeah, a glit.
Mm-hmm. I lose.
Yeah. God, I hate glitter. Holy yeah. shit. It's the worst substance on earth.
Isn't it like really so dangerous?
I think glitter is one of those things that like you'll have once, and if you've ever had it in your lifetime, you will find it 30 years later. Like that's just
yeah, it doesn't go away. It's eternal.
You drop glitter in your house, and it's there forever. There's no way you can get it out.
Get it in a rug. Holy shit, those are high stakes. You better land that kickflip, Bob.
I'm liking this idea. I wonder where I'm gonna have to go to Party City tomorrow.
Yeah, pick up some glitter.
Yeah.
I had heard so much talk about Fob from him doing the intros and Hex and other people just referencing him. This was probably, I don't know, like 6 months ago. And I was kind of like, oh, who the fuck is this man? This man of mystery that I've heard so much about. So I did a deep dive one night. Like, she went to bed early and I was like sitting on my computer. And I was like, now it's time to figure out who this guy really is. And so, like, I, like, Googled it, and then, like, the first thing came up was YouTube, and I was like, oh. I spent the next, like, 3 hours watching all sorts of fantastic skateboard videos. It was the greatest time in my life. And then I went to the stream action, and I went to the mall. And it truly is, like, you guys need to go down on this deep dive, too. Just type in. Into the Googles, type in Fobtac and see where it takes you. It's crazy. But yeah, I had zero idea what I was getting into. I had not heard about skateboarding with fragile objects. I had not heard about them all. I just constantly heard about Fobtac and that you have like a naked Mario in your shower curtain or something.
Oh yeah. And I think I might know where you heard that from.
But yeah, it was fantastic stuff. Yeah, so like I love it. I love it. I am not a skateboarder. I can ride it, and that's about it. So like watching that, and especially wishing that I could do cool stuff, was fantastic.
Wow. Well, thank you. That really means a lot to me. Wow. Yeah, I feel like I don't know. I started YouTube pretty early, 2008, and. Stayed somewhat consistent-ish.
I was gonna say, Fob is like an OG YouTuber since like nearly the beginning, which is crazy. And, it started with skateboarding, like tutorials and stuff, right?
Yeah, and it's interesting because I feel like back in like 2008 YouTube, you could just upload like a video every month, and in 6 months you'd have like 1,000 subscribers, you know. And I feel like it was a lot easier back then. So that's how I started with the skateboarding tutorials. But as YouTube kind of progressed, I kind of realized you kind of have to change or adapt what you're doing a bit. And that's kind of what I tried to do, but. I like skateboarding, you know, so I always try to kind of tie it in somehow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You and I are cut from a similar cloth. Like, I also uploaded some old skateboarding, a lot of old skateboarding stuff to YouTube, really old stuff, stupid little skits, things like that, that for some reason YouTube decided that everybody needs to see now. So,
oh, wow.
So like, my old, like, shitty, like, 2009, like, video of me pretending to get hit by a car skateboarding is like, you know, one of my most viewed videos. This is great video. As of late. Yeah. But so like as an early skateboarding YouTuber, you and I are kind of similar.
Yeah.
And I still skateboard a little bit, but Fob, like, he'll still do like a kickflip off like a 3 foot wall. And actually I remember watching you do that, and I sort of coached you, and like you landed it right after that.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, I feel like, I mean, just even if I didn't help, just let me have this.
No,
I feel like I helped.
You did.
And it makes me feel good.
No, if I was about to shut off my stream and deactivate my Twitch, but I was going to focus my skateboard, and then you came in and, you know, showed me everything. How to do it. Yeah.
No, but like I could feel what you were feeling. I knew what you needed to do. I could tell from looking at your form that you had it in you. You had all the tools, everything at your disposal that you needed. You just needed to commit. And when you did, you landed it.
Perfect. And that's
textbook.
Well, thank you. And that's part of the reason I really like doing live like skateboarding on Twitch. And I'm kind of surprised. I feel like, unless I just haven't found it, I feel like there's not really like a big skateboarding community on Twitch, mm-hmm. which no, surprises is. Me. Because like you said, I feel like it helps me so much when I am trying a trick and chat can say like, oh, try sliding your foot over there or try pushing a little faster or something. Just kind of helping you, like you said.
Yeah. No, Twitch is great for interaction and stuff, and that's what I think propels some of the really cool things of Twitch is chat, being involved and like actually helping with different things. I think that Twitch is a medium that could be a lot better for things like that, skateboarding or whatever. Yeah,
I'm surprised shopping. There isn't more skateboarding. You know what it is? Gamers are lazy. That's what it is.
But it's
started
interesting
as a gaming platform, so yeah, I don't think.
I think it's hard I to feel build like, or go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say, I feel like there's so much that is on Twitch that you wouldn't expect, just like crafts and, I mean, art, you know, is huge. So it is surprising that there's not more skateboarding.
I think like, you know, like, especially like people expect semi-regular content that's similar to what you're doing. So you can't like play a game, skateboard next day, play a game, you know, like... you can, and some people do succeed, but like that's difficult, and then you can't really do a stream before you do like 4 hours of skateboarding every fucking day.
Yeah
That's where, and then
so I feel like consistency with that is difficult.
Yeah, that imagine doing that consistently and then like hurting twisting your ankle and needing to take like a week flight, you know, like.
Well, aside from that, imagine how in shape you'd be. Oh my god. That's not the Twitch way. It's just
the
not.
Twitch way, yeah.
So, Fob, I also wanted to ask you, you know, when you're not skateboarding, you go to the mall, as we discussed earlier, or other places. You have some of the most, like, intricate OBS scenes I've ever seen in my fucking life. Like, how many OBS scenes do you have? How many sources? What kind of spider web? Can you describe your OBS, just the... Holy crap.
Yeah, it gets overwhelming. Actually, I'm going to open it right now. I think I counted like a year ago, and at the time there was like 120 scenes.
By the way.
Yeah. And that was like just for kind of like my main stuff. That was like after I learned that you can like take specific scenes and kind of like upload them, kind of like get them off of OBS and just kind of like pull them later if you need them. So I started doing that too for more like, sometimes we'll go to like the courthouse or
you gotta put some people in jail. Yeah,
exactly.
In jail and stuff like that. Yeah.
So those take up like even more, but yeah, I feel like I kind of almost have to just autopilot through it, because if I start to think too much about like what to click on and where everything is, then I get lost myself.
Yeah. Okay, so... Wait, what was I gonna say? Shit, it completely just left my brain.
Like, oh, do crap. You... Yeah, my thing is, like, it's hard to describe some of the scenes he has, but, like, it is some, yeah, very intricate stuff of, like, he has to stand in a specific area to make sure he's looking at this certain area so they can talk to one of these characters that pops in, and... How do you think before your stream, and are you like, all right, we're going to go to the mall, we're going to do this one, we're going to do this one, we're going to do this one? Or because I wouldn't remember what scenes I have. Number two, I wouldn't remember how to interact
control
with
it?
My
That's
different
what I
scenes.
Wanted to ask. How do you like, do you have like a million buttons bound, or like what do you do there?
Yeah, I did. Oh, shoot. I opened my OBS and I doubled audio. I did start doing, like, keyboard shortcuts and stuff, which helped, but it also kind of added to the confusion, because, like, maybe like a year ago, I went through and like bound two keyboard shortcuts to each person that appears on the stream, basically like to freeze them and to unfreeze them. So I did that, and it like kind of helped to make things look more like realistic, but at the same time, now it's like, oh, I have like 40 keyboard shortcuts I need to remember, and oh, this character's here, how do I unfreeze them? And yeah, it kind of just added to the confusion, but I feel like it kind of just, it started like as just like one or two like wacky overlays. Like I used to have like a drive-through overlay where I'd like be in a car like in a drive-through and order food, and then like be at the window like getting the food, and then that was like pretty much it. And from there I kind of just started like, I would be like in public and think like, oh, this could be like a Twitch overlay. So I would kind of just like take a picture and add that in, and then kind of just kept doing that. And I'm not sure how far it will go before I can't keep track of it, but
and go insane.
Yeah, but I guess we'll find out.
That was the thing that really blew my mind, is you freezing yourself and then like going and taking over the other character. I've spent a decent amount of time on OBS, but I was like, how? I was like, what is this?
Yeah, and that was really one impressive. Thank you. I just thought of it one day, like, oh, I wonder if there's a way to just like freeze a certain source. And there's not like in OBS, but there, someone made like a plugin for it. So I downloaded that and said, oh, cool, now I can like freeze stuff. And then I thought, oh, I wonder if I could like bind this to a hotkey, so I wouldn't have to like click through a bunch of buttons to do it. So that's when I kind of got into the hotkeys, and yeah.
Now the rabbit hole's too deep. You never
exactly. Like, yeah.
But honestly, that's the sorry. Interesting stuff is you never, there's you go into the stream of Fobtac most Fridays. He goes to the mall and does, you know, interactions with different characters that stop by, including Paul Blart, which is the
best.
It's
like a fever dream is what I was going to say. Yeah.
And honestly, it starts out somewhere, and then no matter like what you say in chat affects what's going to happen next. Like when he orders food too, this is the funny thing. He'll say, hey, what do you guys want in chat for food? And he'll order it for you. And somehow, magically, the food comes and shows up and he eats it. And sometimes it's like ice cream, you know, hot dog dipped in ice cream. And you're like, what the fuck did you order, chat? And that's just what you have.
Yeah. A lot of times I don't know how it happens either. But sometimes if there is a strange food asked for, mm-hmm. I'll like not be able to find it in my food inventory and kind of just have to mix foods or improvise or just not show it too closely to the camera.
It turns into some interesting situations when you're just trying to make the close enough thing, and it's like, oh, I'm just gonna put ketchup on this, and that's good.
Yeah, someone asked, oh, they asked for a cheeseburger, oh, well, I have ketchup and rice, is that good enough?
Throw that on
Bob
some bread.
Bob is dedicated. Yeah. You also have a very cool backyard.
Thank you.
Very like cozy, but like functional looking. Little golf holes out there. You got your skateboard ramps and everything. Just looks fun. I admire your backyard.
Thank
it
you.
It looks like a good it's a nice set for the stream. You know it what is. I mean? It's great.
Thank you. Yeah, if you all ever want to come over and, you know, maybe. Hang out in the backyard, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sure at some point I've probably accidentally shown my address on stream or YouTube. You can just come on over.
Great.
Kings is having a heart attack with
that
statement.
That's Fobtac's mainstream. I hope that everyone goes and checks it out, especially on Fridays when he goes to the mall. So go to watch it on Twitch, and then YouTube is a lot of skateboard content and weird, almost like crossovers. Like you did Pokemon stuff, right? And then if you don't land tricks, you actually give cards to people that like are watching your YouTube videos.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like my YouTube is kind of been in a state of trying to find itself for when was 2016? Like 6 years now, but it's fun. You know, I just have fun with it.
I think one time I watched one of your videos where you went and you were getting Pokemon cards in the mall or something, and someone came over and like told you about they were like, oh, you shouldn't do that or something. Like, it was a weird thing.
Yeah, there's this thing in Pokemon cards. Actually, I don't know if it's still a thing, but you used to be able to like weigh the packs of cards, and the heavier packs would, it's like in theory, give you like better cards because the holo foils like weighed slightly more. So I wanted to like test the theory and went to some Targets and bought like a mini scale and kind of just went in there and started weighing some cards to try to find the heavier ones. But nice lady came up and explained to me why it doesn't work anymore. I think you kind of, maybe annoyed that I was doing that.
What year were you doing this around?
I think that was 2016, because I kind of like taken a break for a bit.
I know, like Pokemon cards are big now, not 6 years ago.
Yeah, huh. The Pokemon meta of 2020, he was 4 years early to it.
Yeah, I guess I never thought of that.
Yeah.
Huh. Yeah, it's interesting because, yeah, like 2016, I was really like diving into the Pokemon card, like YouTubers and stuff, and just the community. And yeah, it's interesting to see like how in this past like year or two, it has just exploded.
It's crazy. Yeah. Like people are now trying to pull the Pokemon cards out of their, you know, basement or whatever. It happens every so often, but like right now is like a great time to get, you know, sell anything you have.
Yeah. Yeah, I was going through some of my cards on stream a couple nights ago and kind of just checking some of the prices for fun, and surprised at some of them that I didn't think would be worth anything were, you know, worth like $20, $30 or something.
Yeah.
Are they still so valuable as they were, like, you know, I guess that was like 2020, right? When everyone was like losing their mind over Pokemon.
Oh, that was like 4 months ago,
Yeah, they still had a launch of a new line or whatever, and it sold out like crazy, like the new boxes or whatever, the new packs, boosters.
Yeah. Yeah, it was funny because there was like a couple months there, maybe like late 2021, where I was kind of starting to see Pokemon cards in store again. But then, like you said, the new ones came out, and I haven't seen any in stores in the past few months.
It's crazy. Gotta love fads.
So, all right, changing subjects. Last week we talked to our boy Pestily. He had, you know, talked about he used to get a lot of massages back when he was like in Indonesia with the military. And I had said I had never had a professional massage. You know, I've had like my girlfriend rub my shoulders or whatever. Great, fantastic. And I've always kind of felt like it was like ignorance is bliss. Like, if I realize that, like, I want massages, I'm gonna want them, I'm gonna, like, think about them, I'm gonna, you know, desire it a lot. And so I've always just kind of been like, I'm not fucking with that. And, you know, I ignore it. Valentine's Day, my girlfriend's all like, hey, I got us a group massage this weekend. So I was like, I'm in.
A group massage or a couple's massage? Like, were there more?
No, it was just me and her. Just me and her. I don't know. Yeah, just me and her. So I was all like, okay, well, she didn't tell me what it was. She was all like, we got some things planned this weekend. So then, like, we end up showing up this place, and I was like, oh, God. I guess. And so, like, that also, like, I started being alarmed. I was like, I don't know if I'm ready for this. I was like, what happens? Like, I don't know. And this was like, I don't know, like, the different variations. I cut my finger on the beer lid. I'm bleeding right now.
You're right. You need a bandage.
No, I'm all good. I got paper towel.
We have an editor now. We can
take a break.
But I was like, oh my God. I was like, so is this gonna be like some like massage where they're like dinging bells and doing other stuff, or are they just gonna get in there and like knead my meat? And so I was like, I had no idea, and I was like, oh my God. So like we go in there and they and like put us on our tables and they like the two girls come in and they're all like, well, like what smells do you want? You know, lavender, mint, orange. And I was like, oh, fucking give me the orange. And it was a strange experience. I'm glad. I would like to try it again. I was just nervous as fuck. Like, a massage is supposed to be relaxing. I was out of my mind, just like stressed the entire time.
Why?
Like half the time they were rubbing my feet, and I'm like, if this tickles, I was like, I'm gonna kick her. Because I was like trying not to do stuff, and then they like go to like my calves and my thighs. I was like, oh, okay, this is kind of nice. I like this. But then the oil.
Yeah, mm-hmm. A lot of oil.
So much oil. This is coming from a man that hates showers. I hate being wet, as we have learned. I don't enjoy being wet, and I was very moist and oiled,
slippery.
Yeah, and I don't enjoy that. I did not enjoy the oil. If they could like leave my feet alone, only do my shoulders, my back, my legs, my arms, with no oil. I understand like oil's part of like how they like slide their hands on you and stuff, but like the oil really, really bothered me. And I was terribly upset with that. And I got done and I just felt sticky and oily and gross, but like my muscles felt good. I was like, this is a benefit, or like this is nice, but at the same time, and I felt bad because like she was all like, well, how did it go? And I was like, I don't know, I'm just oily.
She's like breaking down crying.
Honestly, it was a strange scenario. I want to do it again. I feel like if I go in knowing more what to expect, knowing I'm gonna be oily, knowing that like all that stuff, I feel like I could accept it better.
You have to shower there? Like, do you shower after you're done?
They had a shower there, but no, I didn't use it.
Okay.
Every time I've done it, I haven't used the shower there, but I go run and shower immediately because I also hate the oil. I don't like the oil. And like I said, when we were talking about this before, you gotta do it in the airport, in those little chairs where you sit like this. There's no oil, none of that. You don't have to get all naked and everything. I just want some. I want an airport massage. That's better.
You need to go to the airport more often.
Yeah, but I don't go anywhere.
Be a traveling man. Go to the airport. Go like get a ticket to go in. To fly and then never fly.
Yeah, just to never fly anywhere, but get a ticket to get through security and then just get a massage and leave.
Maybe hit Kiva juice while you're there.
Yeah, I think at the second or third time you do that, you might be investigated.
buy some duty free alcohol and cigarettes, smoke them all, drink it all before you leave.
Get a massage. Have you ever tried like a massage gun?
No, I think I would love that. And like, you know, you can go to like the mall and you can sit in like those massage chairs where they're all just like bumping you and doing
those
weird stuff.
Those are terrible.
Like, I like that though. And I just like wanted it like, you know, more personalized and hard. And I'm sure I could find like a massage where they just like beat the shit out of me without oil. And that like, I would be in on that. I think I could get behind that. Like, I want to like get it in there and like really, really make it like, make me in, like in pain a little bit. Just, you know, less oil. But I really do want to try it again. I really want to try it again because I think even if it was like the same one that I got, I think I'd be more prepared. Because I was just like, and the entire time, like even when they were doing parts I liked, I was just sitting there and I was like, all right, I'm in the dark, I have like a towel over my face, and I was like, I don't want to leave my brain to itself like that. I don't want to try and like be quiet and alone because like I just started like going all these weird places and I was like I'm gonna have a panic attack. So yeah, it was a strange experience. Good, definitely some things that I struggled with, but I want to get deeper, which is what I was scared about getting massages. Like, now I'm gonna become some like addict that like constantly wants to go get rubbed down.
I need a rub down.
Yeah, yeah.
One of those guys. I want to do a sensory deprivation take, but I'm also scared, like you said, like I don't want to be left alone with my thoughts for too long, and that's like the whole idea of those things.
That's been on my to-do list for like a weekend plan for a long time. And after doing the massage, I'm like, I don't think I'm ready for that. Before I was like, oh, it'd be cool. Hell yeah. But I'm like, if I started freaking out during a massage, God knows what I'm going to do when I'm floating in lukewarm salt water in a enclosed tank. I'm going to go and it's going to turn into a Dark Mirror episode. I'm going to spend like six lifetimes in there when it's only 10 minutes.
Yeah. Dickie comes out, he's all like grayed.
Like, I've like mentally aged myself to 80 years old.
Yeah. Hey, maybe he like solves, you know, he maybe has the solution to cancer or something. Like, I have the cure. Don't worry about it. It's like, you've been in there 5 minutes.
I know. He comes out. Einstein here.
Eureka. Yeah.
Well, infinite speaking... power.
Speaking of like self-care and like, you know, hygiene, I guess. I think Decky has something else he wants to talk about.
Z-Chum's not here. You are right that I do. Hey guys, it's Manscaped, the sponsor of this stream. I don't know if you guys have heard about Manscaped, but it's a fantastic company that makes products to help groom your nether regions, such as the Lawnmower 4.0, which has a 7,000 RPM motor and some advanced skin-safe technology to help prevent any nicks and cuts down there where it counts. Manscaped has been sponsoring the stream, or the... Guys, I don't... It's very stressful. This is my first time. Z-Chum always does it. But Manscaped always has sponsored the stream, and they still do, and we appreciate it very much. You guys can use code GAMERHOLE to get 20% off at manscaped.com. That's 20% off with code GAMERHOLE, all one word, at manscaped.com. They'll appreciate it, we'll appreciate it, and most of all, you'll appreciate it. So thank you, Manscaped.
And you look good if you ever get a massage. Yeah.
Yeah, well, they're not supposed to be
like, they're not supposed to go down there.
You know,
you can shave your nipples with it. Don't worry about it, guys.
Yeah, yeah, they did come down and like get some like chest action. I like that. That was good. Mm-hmm. In addition to that, it was, she like held my hand. She would like do my arm, and then she'd like take it down, and then she'd like just hold my hand. Not like, we weren't interlocking, we weren't doing anything, but she'd hold it. And that part was the most comforting part of all. Mm-hmm. At that part, I was all like,
human touch.
I was like, it's gonna be okay.
Maybe she realized you were so tense, and she was like, it's okay, buddy. Like.
She could physically feel how tense Decky's muscles were. He's literally
for
like,
real. I'm like, nah. But thank you, Manscaped. We appreciate it.
Decky with his typical streamer brain rot. He's calling the podcast, sponsoring the stream, sponsoring the podcast, but they also do sponsor our streams too, which is cool.
Don't worry about it.
I think I do have streamer brain rot. I can't remember. I don't know if it's like the past couple of years with the pandemic or me getting older or that I stream a lot more, but I can't remember goddamn anything. I feel like you guys feel that way, Fob, right? Like, I'm a mess. It's pathetic.
No, yeah. I what scares me is sometimes I'll be going along my day and I'll think, what did I have for breakfast? Or like, what did I watch like while I was eating breakfast? And I really have to rack my brain sometimes just to remember something that was a few hours ago.
Yeah. And like small little tasks that are like outside of my normal routine take so much more effort now. Like I've been meaning to send an email for like a week. I haven't gotten around to sending. I mean, it's one that doesn't have to do with, you know, anything to do with like my online business.
Otherwise, I'd be sending
whatever.
That way, it doesn't have to wait, take a week.
That's true. I mean, that's what King says. But, you know, just like so a personal matter that I've been just putting off because it's not in my usual routine. I'm like so bad about stuff like that lately. Sucks. I can't do anything. I can't remember to do it or make time to do it.
Ugh. Ever since I started taking my like this is something in general that like, you know, you get older, time goes faster and faster and faster. And like there's like whole like scientific reasoning behind it because like, you know, as a child you haven't experienced much time, so time goes slowly. Then as you experience more time, it goes more rapidly. I don't know the details on it. I've heard it and it kind of makes sense in my brain. It's kind of, you know, I got a lot of, it's not a lot of wrinkles. But I started taking, like, for the most part, I don't have a big schedule in my life besides the stream. And that's just the schedule and that's it. You know, I stream and then I'm done and then I do other stuff, you know, whatever I want. And then I started taking Spanish lessons, like, officially, like, you know, 6 months ago or something. And it's only twice a week and it's like 2 hours every time. But that has single-handedly sped up every minute of every day by like 5 times. It's terrible. Days just scream by and then I'm back at the Spanish lesson. It's all based on these Spanish lessons. And before, like, you know, a day would used to be, it's still pretty short. I'm getting older, still pretty short. But now it's just like 5 minutes goes by. I swear I just woke up this morning and here I am and it's bedtime.
Yeah, I do that too. Yeah.
And I guess having this like consistent thing that I don't really look forward to, and then I always just wind back up at it again and again and again, and I'm right fucking there again, and it's bad.
Yeah,
so
I feel you.
I don't know where I'm going with this, but it's.
Are you learning Spanish?
Give me like 6 years, and I'll be able to maybe have a conversation. I'm really dumb when it comes to that stuff.
Yeah.
How are you learning it?
I pay a guy named Christopher on, and we have like some website thing.
Let me ask you this: Te gustas?
Something about are you?
Te gustas su? What are those called in Spanish? Cerveza.
What?
Te gustas su cerveza? Your beer?
Do you like your beer?
Yes, very much. Thank you. Sí,
me gusta mucho.
Interesting.
You just have to think of the old Rage comics.
But yeah, it stresses me out. Like having that thing that reoccurs that I don't really look forward to. It's amazing how fast it comes back up, and it is single-handedly just like doubled or tripled the speed of my days/weeks.
Yeah, I think that if you make your schedule full, your days seem like they are just already gone. Like you're like, oh, like I work 7 days a week and like there's so much stuff that piles on recently that it's like I wake up and then I'm doing stuff and then I'll like, you know, do some other stuff, talk to some people, and then I'll be like, wait, it's 11 o'clock at night already. And then you're like, fuck. And then the next day you do the same thing where you wake up and you got stuff to do. And while you're doing it, you don't notice how long it's taking you. And then
exactly.
End of the day.
Yeah. I feel like if you kind of like look at it, or how I try to do it is like look at it in your head is like I try to think of something that's like happening that I want to like be done, like the pandemic or something, and if I ever think like, oh wow, so much time has passed, then I think, oh well, at least, you know, we're closer to this happening, or, you know, maybe more time has passed since, like, you get a bad haircut or something like that. And then at the other way, I try to think like just kind of like the opposite of that. Like if it feels like time is going too slow, I kind of try to just think like, oh, well, at least this thing is still happening, this good thing, you know, and it kind of helps.
So you look at like the positives of whatever.
I guess so. Yeah. Just kind of try to compare the two of them to.
Yeah.
Also significant.
Most people
are good.
Wait till Saturday, right? Isn't that like the big thing for most people that like work Monday through Friday? They're like, oh, well, at least it's
Friday.
You know, Saturday. At least it's Friday and I get the weekend. And I don't think as streamers you get that as much because it's kind of like whatever your schedule is.
Do weekends feel like weekends for you guys?
I stream Monday through Friday, so they do to me.
Yeah. I don't have weekends, so I don't know.
They feel different for me, but I kind of just, because like everybody around me, the weekend is more of a thing. So like, I still feel the weekend. I get it. I get the weekend.
The weekend's important.
Yeah.
I've had my schedule to where I streamed on the weekend and shit, and that, it fucks me up. I need that weekend.
Yeah.
I should keep more regular weekends. I end up streaming on the weekends sometimes a lot too.
A lot of times I try and get myself to stream and then and it fucks it up. And then I'm like, we're not doing this.
The problem with not streaming on the weekends, and this is the problem with streaming, is like, what else are you going to do? And then like, is it considered like a waste of time for you not to stream if you're already playing games?
It's
like a weird thing.
I like to do stuff with other people if I have plans on the weekend. But if I don't, nothing's going on, and I feel like I could stream, I like to stream because I like to take days away from stream where I feel like I really need it. You know what I mean? Some days I'm just like, I can't do that today. I don't want people like looking at me today. Like that kind of thing. Or, I don't know. You know what I'm trying to say. I like to pick those days when I need them, you know? So.
And not just take Saturday and Sunday just because it's Saturday and Sunday. Yeah.
I feel like whenever I, like, end up with, like, free time, I always feel like I need to, like, fill it with something productive. So I'll end up, like, spending my day off just, like, cleaning or something. And it's like, yeah, I'm glad that I got cleaning done, but I kind of wish I had watched a movie or played some video games or something too.
It's just crazy.
I'm not good at like, I like feel like I don't even know how to relax, you know? How do you like have downtime? Like I feel guilty whenever I do nothing.
Yeah, same here.
I want to feel good about doing nothing. I can't do anything. It's like it like ruins it, you know? How do I do this? Does anyone know? I feel like all of us don't really know.
You can't ask me yet. Don't ask me about that.
Yeah.
I turn off pretty good.
Yeah.
Like, after my streams at night, I'm like, that's it. And then I lay and watch Love is Blind Season 2. Oh, so good.
Watched Season 1. My girlfriend fell asleep to that on at Season 1, and it just went on the TV as I'm awake. And I'm sitting there reading emails and typing, and I look over, and I'm just watching this dumbass show. Sorry for the tangent, but Love is Blind, okay, is terrible. Okay, they're like, you can't see anyone. Okay, so the concept is okay. You can't see them, and you have to learn about them and talk to them, but the show doesn't show that much, and then they have to propose without seeing the person. Literally propose.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, it's not just date. They propose, they can still bail out of it because after they propose, they get to see each other. And then they have like 3 weeks until their marriage. Yeah. Okay, yeah. They have some weeks until they get married. Yeah, it's great. It's high stakes.
How long do they have to do this before the proposition?
Like,
I can't tell. It's really quick though.
Yeah, they have like 3 weeks or 4 weeks of talking to each other through a wall.
Fuck proposes after 3-4 weeks.
Desperate people. The show makes me feel so fucking weird. There's like these 28-year-olds on the show, and they're like, I have to find a person I'm gonna marry. And I'm like, bro, I'm 30 fucking four.
Yeah, like calm down, you know? Like,
and they're like, I have to find my mate, so I'm gonna join this show so I get married. I'm like, what the hell is goddamn going on in this shit? And it makes me feel all weird. I'm like, what world am I living in? Because I'm clearly not on the same level as these people. And but then other times I'm all like, this is kind of wholesome. It's got a cool theme to it. I enjoy the show.
It starts wholesome and it's great, but one time I saw some guy propose to one girl, she turned him down, and then, like, the next day he proposed to the next girl. What the fuck?
I love it. I love it. I've just gotten through, like, I got, like, a couple of more episodes left. So, like, they talk to each other through the wall, then they propose, and then they see each other, and there's nobody extremely hideous or anything on the show. You know, it's got to be fair.
They're all really attractive. They're pretty attractive people.
You
like,
get a couple of weird people, but yeah, they're all generally attractive.
Isn't this like the same concept as like the original dating show, like reality show?
What, The Bachelor? He sees kind all of them. Yeah, he just goes on dates with all of them.
Like, this is like the dating show from the 70s or something.
Yeah, the one from like the 70s where they had to talk through a wall and like.
So they ask questions and answer, right? And then you have to go on they like get a date with one. Like,
but it's marriage.
This is marriage.
It's marriage, Aqua.
So it's irresponsible.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, really irresponsible.
So
it might be completely fake, but if they actually do get married, fuck, this show's fucked up. Like,
they had season one from like 2.5 years ago, and some of those people are still together. It's fantastic stuff. It's great TV. Yeah.
Wow.
But yeah, then they have to live together for a couple of weeks until their wedding, and that brings all sorts of drama because, you know, they've only known each other for like 2 weeks through a wall. Mm-hmm. And then they're all like, oh, this guy, you know, snores, or oh, this guy's like a picky eater, or oh, this guy's, you know, not, I don't think he's hot. And so like they always have all these conflicts, and it's great. And then half the time they're like, they have them meet each other. So like they propose to one guy, then maybe that guy had a connection with somebody else, and then they bring that other girl in, and he's all like, "Oh shit, girl, how you doing?" And but he's already engaged with this other chick, and the other girl's already engaged with somebody else. But then they both want to like fuck each other, and then they have to get married. But yeah, it's great. It's great.
Dude, I'm telling you, we're making the next Twitch show. We need to find some desperate people. That's all. God. Desperate streamers. We got this.
Holy shit.
The show is wild.
Yeah.
It's bonkers. Like, it is annoying how, like, crazy a lot of the stuff is. And that's what my girlfriend fell asleep, and she's like, oh, this show, I'm going to just turn it on. Out within 2 seconds, right? Turns it on, first episode, she's out. And then I'm like, okay, no big deal. But then every once in a while, something ridiculous will happen. I'll be like, what the fuck? And I'll just like look over at the TV. Like one of them where they're like, oh, I'm very religious, super religious. And that's like, my girlfriend did see that part and was like, first red flag was she was like, thank God. And you know, so she was like super religious, like to the point of like craziness religious. And the guy was like, yeah, I'm atheist. And she's like, what? Like she's all pissed that he...
Oh my god.
And then she's like, well,
it's gotta be fake.
If we have kids, will you let them like, and he's like, yeah, they can go to church until they're at an appropriate age and then choose, you know, type of thing. And but if they want my opinion, I'm gonna say like what I believe in, you know, I'm not gonna force it. And they can choose when they become an appropriate age or something like that. And she's like, that's not acceptable. You can't let them choose. And it's like, what the fuck? And then I think he ends up proposing to this woman, like what?
Major spoilers here, King. God, bro. God. This is all true. But God,
gotta get
King.
Married. ASAP. Okay?
This is all season one, 2.5 years ago. Not season two, so. Anyways, yeah, it's crazy. It's bonkers. I don't understand, but Decky and I both love some of the dumb, like, TV shows that come
I love.
Like
well, it's really only that one and then the Too Hot to Handle where, like, all the hot young singles can't fuck on the island. That one's great. Yeah.
That like British one where they all just go to an island and like bang
bang or they lose their money out of the pot at the end, so they like they advertise the show to all these hot young people and they're like, come on this island with all these hot sexy singles, and then they get out there and like, you can't fuck her or else it's gonna make you lose money. And
also,
so then they all, it's so good.
Do you know what else is weird? That same girl is in like three different ones. That Essex girl, the girl from Essex.
Yeah,
that,
dude, she crosses over into Love is Blind because then she wants to hook up with that dude, which is clearly just a producer's goddamn milking shit, but I'm in. Exactly. I'm in.
Yeah, she was in the circle too.
I didn't ever watch that. We need to move subjects. Everybody's going to stop watching.
So sorry, everyone. This is weird stuff.
Aren't there? I feel like there's like some people who have like legitimately gotten like at least a small level of like mainstream fame just from being on like Survivor. Yeah. Like I used to watch Survivor back in the day, and I think his name was Rupert. He was on like every season, and they just kept bringing him back, and it's crazy
He was a fan favorite during the pirate one because he acted like a fucking pirate. Like
yeah. He was just a normal guy and went on the show and then became kind of big in the limelight.
Mm-hmm. That's crazy. I actually met one of the female contenders that I think got second place or third place in season one, I want to say, because my friend's dad dated her for a short time.
Oh,
so,
wow.
Like, we played, we taught her how to play poker because she had to do a charity poker tournament or something. And we actually met her and it was fun. And her who she was dating, my friend's dad, were like, yeah, we've got a poker tournament we have to do, blackjack or something, and she's never played because there's some celebrity whatever. And I was like, okay. And then we taught her, it was fun. But yeah, that was the only thing. But I don't understand, like, there is people that are like career extras, and I feel like that's the worst job ever. But now, what's his name? The one that does Feature Man? The one that does the YouTube channel?
Oh, I love Feature Man.
Yeah. He was a career extra. He just was like, you know, he just, you need someone to be like the barkeep in the back? Sign that guy up, you know, $50 a day or whatever.
True. Is that... No. That's not the guy with like the curly hair. Is it? Is that someone else who's in?
No, he's like an old man. He's like an old man.
Feature Man's old. Yeah.
And he does like food videos, like him like making like hot dogs sliced up and like all these weird like old man food recipes. He's amazing.
It's how to live frugal. A lot of it. Like it's very, you know, I eat this can of soup and it's, you know, it lasts me 2 days or something when I make this and it's only 89 cents. And He throws in like other ingredients to make it better, but he's like, this whole meal might cost me $4.
Oh, he's
like,
great. Well, great YouTube channel feature, man.
I'll have to check that out.
It has nothing to do with his past as like a career extra or anything. Yeah.
Sometimes
he stories.
He talks about
he's
eating.
The stories. Yeah, he talks about it. Yeah. He's the best.
Most interesting man, really. Like his life and crazy stories are great.
One of my favorite YouTube channels, 100%.
Yeah.
You know, like, Bob, we've talked about this in the past, but I want to hear from you. Like, do you watch any, like, weird, like, because, like, a lot of people, like, with me, for instance, they're like, oh, did you watch, like, so-and-so's new, like, Tarkov video? Did you see this Rust video, blah, blah, blah? I'm like, I don't really watch that stuff so much. I'm watching, like, Feature Man. I want to see this man slice up hot dogs, put it in soup, and eat it. And talk about like being in a movie in the 60s, you know, like shit like that. Do you watch like anything weird on YouTube that's like kind of like unexpected or like interesting?
I feel like I watch like a lot, but I feel like it's all like pretty popular. I'm scrolling through my subscriptions now to see.
I actually know something that Fobtac watches on stream when he's at the mall sometimes, and it's always random, like teaching you how to be like an accountant at whatever or wherever. It's just like random old promotional videos of like how to learn how to be an associate wherever.
That's true.
It's the
funniest
thing.
Yeah, I do. I have a certain softness for like instructional videos made for the workplace. I like, you know, different decades. I like different categories just based off the time period. I like seeing restaurant training videos from like the early 2000s. I like seeing like Walmart training videos from like the mid 2000s, forklift training videos from the 90s.
Those are the good years. Yeah.
Yeah, something about it. Okay, Bob Farrell, I would recommend just searching Bob Farrell pickle on YouTube.
Oh, God.
It's not bad.
It's really fun. It's really good. It's like a motivational speaker type of deal.
Yeah. Something about it. It's almost pickle. Like comforting. Bob Farrell.
Bob Farrell.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's weirdly comforting.
I can hear it right now.
I can hear it, yeah.
I love doing. Yeah. Then when they came in.
Who's playing
at
Bob Pickle right now?
Let's see how.
Who is that? Is that you, Fobtac?
That's not me.
Wow.
Wait, could you guys down. You guys hear my video?
Yeah, we can hear it. It's routed through. Yeah.
Oh. Well,
I was looking at Bob Farrell's pickle. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Decky gave you a glimpse, but you guys can search it up. But freaking, it was the greatest thing to watch some of the weird stuff that comes up.
You know what's
so weird?
If you're
not enjoying them all, you can enjoy the little infomercials that you get to watch.
That's a good answer. That's unusual. I haven't heard anyone say that. Like for me, like to relax, sometimes I watch like chiropractor videos or whatever, or like weird things like that on YouTube. And I fall asleep with my laptop like almost every night. And I always wake up and open my laptop and I'm like, I wonder what video, because I have autoplay on.
Yeah. So I'm like, where my laptop dies, you know, every night, I'm always in the same fucking video. It's like a 3 hour long video of like a lecture or like doctor's conference about shoulder impingement. For some reason, whenever I wake up, plug in the power of my laptop and open it up, it's always on this fucking video every night. It's so weird. But anyways, you know, just a little look into my morning. First thing I see is shoulder impingement.
Have you ever gone to a chiropractor?
No, too scared, but I like to watch it.
I've been popped. Like, we've talked about this.
Yeah.
But, like, I want to go back. I want that. I'm like, I want to try all these new things, especially after this massage thing, even though that didn't go great. Like, I want to get out there. I want to have my body used, touched, like... Okay, all of this sounds bad. Broken. I want to try these things, okay? I want to try stuff. That's it.
Would you try acupuncture?
I got a problem with needles. I got a real problem with needles. I would like to try maybe the where they put the suction cups on your back.
Ooh, that one scares me.
I would take that over the acupuncture. Yeah. I wish I could do the acupuncture, but I don't know.
I think I would rather acupuncture than Zucky cups.
I don't want like a needle like in my lip or like right here. Oh god, fuck that, dude. It seems like it hurts.
What if it's just your shoulder? Like, let's say it's your arm, your shoulder, like top of here, and it was cupping or acupuncture. Which one?
I'd rather have cupping.
I'd get cupped, yeah.
I'd get poked.
Yeah, I'd get cupped.
Fuck. I feel like neither of those could possibly do anything. Like, I mean, I'm not a doctor, obviously, or someone who, you know, is an expert on it. Yeah, I've seen a lot of YouTube videos about this stuff. But, like, those, like, I don't think, maybe it, like, feels good. I don't think chiropracting is, like, we've talked about this a million times, but I think it probably just feels good, but doesn't actually help you do it with anything. Just fun to do.
I don't know.
The only thing I know about chiropractors
is the fact that it's not actually recognized by, like, most medical boards. So, I don't know.
It's like getting a massage.
I just unlocked a memory that I've been cupped before, and it was, I was skateboarding one time, and I had a fall that, like, at the time, I was trying to ollie something and kind of just, like, clipped in and kind of fell on my side a bit, and I felt fine at the time, and, you know, everything was normal, but later in the day, like, my whole leg just, like, froze, and, like, I couldn't move it for some reason, and it was kind of stuck like that, so I ended up going to a place, I don't really know what it was, but there was a guy there who, I guess he did kind of, like, massage, like, my leg and press really hard, and he ended up doing cupping on it, and I forgot that happened, but he actually, he did it where there was somehow, like, a fire. He would, like, put fire in. He put the fire there and then, like, put that there and then just, like, pulled it. And it hurt a lot, and I couldn't tell you if it did anything, but I had bruises for, like, a week on my leg afterwards.
You got cuffed, bro? Yeah.
I got cupped. Wow.
Did it help your leg? Did it unfreeze your leg?
I mean, my leg unfroze, but I don't know if it was because of that or not. I feel like it kind of just... a few days later, I think it just healed.
No, I know people that used to get cupped a lot because it was, I think, a big thing when I was playing, like, to get that sort of thing and be rolled out and all this other dumb stuff for athletes. But I never did it because it was just... I never understood it fully. But I think even physical therapists learn, you know, the basics of that now. It's just like, because it is what it is I think it pulls the muscles towards you, and that's the whole point of the cupping. So it pulls it away from, like, bone and stuff and gives it so it actually moves. I don't know. I didn't finish a physical therapy degree, so don't worry about that. But acupuncture is something that also I don't think I do. Both of them, I can understand why they would work sometimes, but at the same time... not enough where I'm comfortable to have like something shoved in me.
You know, I'm good with needles too. I don't really mind. I don't care about needles too much. I still don't want that.
Oh no, like I'm good with needles. I just don't like
that. I'm the opposite. Yeah. I think if I was better with needles, I'd be in on acupuncture. Mm. But really? I'm like needles fucking scare the shit out of me. But like I don't know, maybe that's some weird shit that I'm telling myself. But like yeah, in my head I'm like, oh dude, that'd be sick if they could fucking goddamn like have like 50 fucking needles poking all out of me in different places. But like I am very scared.
Huh. Like imagine like falling off the table or something and the needle just goes like way like far into you.
Yeah, imagine walking across in the street and get hit by a car. Give me a break, Aqua. Yeah.
I know. Or imagine, but that's like so much creepier to think about.
Imagine you're on the table with the needles and the building catches on fire and you have to run outside with a bunch of needles and try to not get
That was in my head.
You get hit by a car, and then the
That was in my head. I was getting this massage, and I'm on this like rickety table, and I'm sitting there getting rubbed down, and I'm in my boxers under this like little towel thing, and I was all like, "What happens when there's an earthquake? I'm like six stories up. I'm in this concrete building. For one, like I'm gonna have to run out naked." Almost naked. That's gonna be kind of weird. Number two, like I'm not making it down.
You didn't get fully naked.
No,
I think you're supposed to.
No, no, Decky, did they ask you get undressed to your comfort level?
No, they're just like, they're just like, yeah, get under the cover
under
thing.
The sheet.
Yeah, they kind of like, they assumed I knew what was going on. I didn't.
Listen, I've had a few massages. One time they were like, get naked. I was like, what? Like naked? And they were like, yes.
Yeah. Oh.
And I was like, oh. Okay.
Well, it makes
and
sense. Like,
and they spent like 20 minutes rubbing my butt.
Yeah.
Oh, she didn't rub my butt at all.
Yeah, because you didn't get naked. Thing. If you did, she would have rubbed
your butt.
Did
she rub your butt? Did she rub your butt at the massage? Did she rub your ass? Yeah, me either. But Aqua's saying he got a massage and he got his ass rubbed.
Yeah. Big time.
Wow. Yeah, no, like there was no ass rubbing there.
Mostly that. It was remarkable. I was like,
maybe your butt's
there are
tense.
Other parts of my body. Hell yeah, I got a tense butt.
She said she's going to tell your wife.
What? She's saying?
She said she's going to tell your wife that the masseuse was rubbing your ass.
She knows she was there. Her butt probably got rubbed too.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I think that's a massage like that is. I think that a lot of times it's common where you're supposed to get naked and they just rub your butt. And what's wrong? You know,
it's a big muscle.
I feel like I really missed out then. Yeah. But yeah, like that's the shit that was running through my head. Like I was trying to relax, but instead my head was just going all these dark places and all like freaking me out even more.
See, now you're going to be weird because you're going to be like, am I supposed to take my boxers off?
Yeah, next time, that's exactly what's going to fucking happen. I'm going to be like, am I? I'm like, is she going to think that I'm weird because I didn't take my boxers off? Does she want to rub my butt, but
take
she's not rubbing my butt?
When you're not supposed to take
them
off.
Yeah, is she going
to
think I'm a pervert because I took my boxers off, but she doesn't want to rub my butt?
The only time I had done it, it was very clear instructions. I was like, all the way?
That's the way it should be. Right? It should be like, there should be like a little procedure board that you know, like, oh, first time here, this is what you do. Boom, 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 boom. This is what's going to happen, too. Like, you got to know.
They should have like a screen with like a tutorial, like, before you go in, like,
an
like
instructional video.
Laser tag.
An instructional
exactly.
From the early 2000s.
Exactly.
Right.
And I wonder if one exists.
Oh, they do. I watch them.
Yeah, but
when you on YouTube,
you end up on shoulder impingement at, you know, 4 a.m. Trust me.
Wow. This has been wonderful. We've learned about massages, Aqua's ass being rubbed for 30 minutes, you know. Yeah. I swear, maybe it's just your butt was so tense from freaking sitting on it all day, you know? Like
probably.
You sit on it too much. And
I mean, a butt
like,
massage would be great.
Yeah.
That seems like an amazing thing.
All you have to do is, It was, you know, it was great. It was. Yeah. It was nice. It was a unique experience. I will say that.
But you're 100% correct. That's the most awkward part, too, is like, You leave the boxers on, you're supposed to take them off, or you take them off and you were supposed to leave them on. That's like,
yeah, what if you, how presumptuous? How are you going to just take them off? There needs to be set rules.
Maybe you go in, okay, you go in with pants on, regular pants, and shorts underneath those, and boxers underneath those. You go in and you kind of just take off the first layer of pants and see how they react, and if that's a no-go, then, oh, I'm wearing shorts, you know?
But, surprise.
What you need is you need to wear a thong underneath your underwear. That way you can take off your underwear and still have something on in case they're like, whoa.
That's the answer. Everybody, if you get a massage, wear a thong. Then they can still rub your butt. And then, like, you know.
If you're not supposed to, it's just, you know, you have a thong on still.
You're not fully naked. Yeah. So then it's not, like, weird.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the way. All right, I'm glad we solved this.
We solved it for everyone that wants to get a massage.
Everyone
in
the
life
world.
Thong sales are about to skyrocket.
Invest now. Guys, buy our official thong NFT on gamehole.com.
Oh. I have two things that I could rant about for a long time. One of them being, you know, the lawsuit coming out against Jake Paul or whatever. But, you know, we don't need to go in that too deep. But Jesus Christ, there's so many weird things that have happened recently.
I don't even know what happened.
Me either.
There's a formal lawsuit that's out on the people that pushed NFTs, one instance of the NFT pushing. And they've listed all the people, and you can file a formal thing with the state and not end up being anything, but it does mean that there actually is investigation proceedings that'll happen, and a lawyer's been hired. That's pretty much all it means, but the pump and dump, essentially, the rug pull, they're trying to cut down on. And the FTC is now also getting involved because everyone's being more strict on FTC guidelines. So if you're a streamer, disclose if you get paid, because it will come down eventually.
Yeah. I noticed I did a sponsor the other day, as you know. Had to be a very, very, like, have to have a thing on screen.
Yeah.
Saying it was an ad, which is new.
Yeah. It just depends on the ad and how crazy they're about it. But yeah, you always disclose, obviously, but now I think it's going to get stricter and stricter because people were pretty loose with the whole crypto thing. Because they thought, you know, no one can trace it. So why do I have to disclose if no one traces?
I'm brand new to, like, getting sponsored stuff. So I'm still learning about all of it. And I definitely worry that I'm going to mess something up or forget to disclose something and go get in trouble. So,
I mean, the main thing is, as long as you do everything as an honest way and you tell people what's happening, you're fine. You're in the clear. As long as you in some way make it clear, like, yeah, I'm being paid to, you know, play this game on stream or whatever, you're fine. But like, if people are like, well, I'm not, you know, I'm not paid, I'm playing this on my own, then it's like, okay, come on. And that's what happened with crypto, was people were like, well, they didn't really pay me. Instead, they gave me $300 million worth of the crypto. I don't know if that's, you know, and then, yeah. Being paid in other currency still counts as being paid.
Huh. Totally off subject. Did Elden Ring come out today?
No.
No, it comes out the 27th, I believe.
Oh. No,
if I'm correct.
25th.
25th, sorry. 25th.
Oh, I thought it was today, because, like, everybody...
Actually, the 24th. Sorry.
Everybody, like, last night on Twitter was like, I'm going to bed thinking about Elden Ring. I thought it was literally today. Yeah, I was going to ask if you had played.
I noticed that too, and like I was like double check today. I was like, wait a minute, did it come out? I was seeing some clips and things on YouTube, and
well, people did get access early. There's a couple people that did get access.
Okay. Yeah, but like, I legit thought it, I'm like, I'm not gonna play it, so I wasn't really tracking it. But I was like, I know Aqua's gonna be in.
Who was it? One of the streamers, I think, said that they got to play 2 hours of it or something like that, and they were like, well, I thought I'd play 2 hours of it and I'd get it out of my system. But now that I've played 2 hours, it's all I'm going to think about till it comes out. Because I think they had a time window they were allowed to play.
I'm very excited. Very excited. It looks like it's going to be...
I wish I had the hype everybody else does. I wish. I'm not there.
All I hope that it doesn't get ruined by people. Like, I think that playing a game brand new, not knowing what's going into it, especially that type of game, is really good.
You and can't have you a spoiler. Kind of... There's no storyline to any Souls games.
Oh, yeah, but even... there's going to be angry people in chat. I'm
there's
just
going to be tons of angry comments. But no, like that, and also
how
like
could you say that
the patterns of bosses, even that kind of stuff. Like if you don't know what's coming, your first kind of death is like, oh, that was cool. Like they, you know, the next phase happened and I died randomly. Whereas I think a lot of people are going to ruin it by watching a streamer, figuring it out and metaing it. And then,
well, games like that, a lot of people don't like to play them themselves. They'd rather watch someone else play.
No, 100%. And I'm that way with those type of games because I don't want to play it. I love watching it. I don't want to play it. But I mean, like the people that want to play it, I think we've gotten to the thing where like people want to meta games all the time. And then it's like, especially that type of game, I feel like you shouldn't meta. You should just play it yourself and then
and finding all the secrets and shit and then not everyone knows where everything is. And
speaking of that, good Cyberpunk 1.5 came out and now the game's back, baby.
Great. I've actually really wanted to re-pick it up and play it off stream.
I'm going to yeah
like I waited over a year and I was like, I think now I might, if I get time off stream, I might fuck with it.
Because they fixed a lot of stuff. They added a shit ton. I guess it's like a huge amount of stuff they added. It was like a 50 gigabyte patch for 1.5. So that alone is going to make it better.
I got it on sale a while back, and I've just kind of been sitting on it, just waiting for the patches and stuff.
Yeah. 1.5 is a good one to get into, so look into it.
Lastly, did you guys pre-order that Steam Deck?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because that's supposed to start shipping. Like, you're supposed to get the emails if you earn the, like, the first batch on, like, the 25th.
Were you in first batch? I was second.
I don't remember. Batch. I don't know. Like, where do you see what batch you're in? Like, when I go to the thing, it says Q2, so I'm bummed out. But I was, like, 40 minutes, man. I was 40. 40 minutes is a lot of fucking people before me. Probably, yeah. I'm bummed as shit, though, dude.
My
bummed
girlfriend
as
did
shit.
It, luckily. I couldn't even get into Q2 because my thing kept saying we don't accept your like payment. Or,
yeah,
it wasn't
everybody
payment.
Had
you
that
had
issue.
You had to keep clicking. Yeah, you know, and it kept having issues. So I didn't even get into Q2 myself. So luckily, my girlfriend was doing it at the same time as she did Q2.
Z-Chum's like this, you know, Valve guy. Like he worships everything they fucking do, and he got in like super late, didn't he? I think.
Yeah, he was after. He was third batch, I think.
Yeah, he was like after all of us. Is what like from what I remember when that first launched. But I'm so bummed because I was like, I'm pumped about it. I want it. But now I know I'm gonna be like summertime. I'm gonna get an email, and at that point, it won't fucking goddamn matter.
Yeah.
I'm hot.
Do you think they're gonna be like hard to get for a really long time, even after release?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Two, three years probably.
Yeah, that was my worry.
They're so cool for like.
There is other things like it. By the way, there is a lot of other options out there like it. I just think that for the price that it costs and what you get, the Steam Deck is the only one that...
The Nintendo Switch is kind of like that, you know, with a much more limited library, but...
But that has to be Nintendo games only.
No. Yeah.
The Switch?
Yeah. It's got a whole indie market on there. Like, all kinds
but it's,
of games.
It has to... It's for the coded for the Switch. It's not an actual computer on your hands.
Yeah. It's different.
Yeah, but... Yes, it's different. But there is ones out there that are computers that are handheld. Like, there's actual... But like a lot of them that I know are like $2,000 plus, and then
you're
like,
does the Steam Deck just like straight up like run Windows on it?
It runs Linux. That's the big thing.
It runs Linux, but it's its own thing. It's a whole computer in your hands.
So a lot of games on Steam have been getting like compatibility for Linux builds. Like DayZ got it, and then like I'm so pumped. It's not gonna run everything on Steam, but a lot of games have really been pushing for it.
I wonder why they chose Linux.
Because isn't there like a long it has to do with like Microsoft and Windows, right? And kind of like the competition between Microsoft and Valve, I think.
Yeah, I don't know what the legality would be of them.
They probably just couldn't work out a deal or something.
Yeah. I don't know how that works.
Yeah, I don't know.
Interesting. But yeah, it's a computer in your hands. And the good thing about the Steam Deck is that he believes that you own it, so you can do whatever the fuck you want with it.
Oh, yeah, they're like, yeah, right,
iPhones, right, you know, it's very customizable and everything.
iPhones, you, if you open it up, you broke their terms of service, and they're really pissed at you. Whereas, you know, he's like, do whatever the hell you want with it. You bought the, you know, the thing. So, that's
cool. It's a nice mentality to have.
Yep. So, yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. We're going to wrap up here. It's been over an hour. Thanks to all the new members and all the new viewers that came from the Pestley one, which was one of the best podcasts we've probably done. A lot of cool topics. Great talking to you, Fobtac. Ben, sorry to make you do this, but can you throw in another clip of Fobtac's stream? Probably something about throwing someone in jail. And then thanks, Fobtac. Make sure to check him out on Twitch and YouTube for Skateboard, Holding Delicate Stuff. Always hard to watch. And then the Friday night, make sure to check out the mall.
Thank you, Fobtac. Thanks for letting me be here. This was really, really nice, really fun time.
Yeah, thank you for joining us. And thank you guys for watching. We'll see you next Thursday and every Thursday. Forever.
Forever.
Okay. Oh, shoot, I just spilled all the tots. okay, thank you. Oh, we got... there are tots everywhere. We got the... the Halo top. Okay, next location. Are you saving the blue ones for Akray? Oh yeah, I can save the blue ones for Akray. Oh look, you can see all. Look at all the tots. On the... what is happening? Okay.
Hey, thank you for watching the Gamer Hole today. I hope you enjoyed your time in the hole with us. I know we did. If you want to support the channel even further than just watching it, which we appreciate so much, you know, because let's face it, we're not exactly, you know, we're not great conversationalists, but we try. But if you want to see some exclusive content, every week we do a special episode as well as the occasional live stream, you know, just some extra stuff. You can join, the members program here on YouTube. There's a little join button down below the video there. Check it out if you want to, you know, get some extra stuff or even just support what we're doing here. Either way, we'll see you again next week, every Thursday, forever. Okay, thanks again.